everybody, and welcome to Dark DJ Productions once again. And today we're doing another race. We're being incredibly racing, for lack of a better word. So what are we doing? So me and the boys are again going to be doing another race, and we're going to be running from Swansea to Shrewsbury, which is a distance of very far. So without further ado, let's introduce our racers for the day. We are sat in a public VC, so some people might join, but will. If I have to pull people out, I will. Anyway, look at these bunch of plebs.
How about no?
All right, thanks for that, Kobe. That was the literal introduction. So who we got? We got James. Say hi.
Hello.
We got Kobe.
Yo.
We've got Liam.
Oh, shit. You're back. Hi.
And we've also got Intrepid.
Hello, peoples.
Hello. So, yeah, I was explaining the plan. We are taking Fat Man, a.k.a. Rick, a.k.a. DR1202, on my end, because Liam has basically challenged me here. He says that I can't beat him in Rick. So I don't know whether I can actually beat him in Rick, because he's driving a king, I think.
Maybe if I didn't choose it. Actually, no. No 8K would lose to Rick.
I don't know, because that. Again, I don't know about his speed capability, because I think you can go faster than me. But either way, I wanted Nick Hugh to drive Rick over a long distance, and the long distance is 151 miles. So this could be fun for water as well.
Hmm.
So, I don't know when we're going to actually leave, but I'm just letting my fire warm up a little bit. Which I think is a good idea for everybody to make sure they're all set up for. But yeah, we're here at Swansea. I don't know how you pronounce it in Welsh. It's abattoir. It's the abattoir. Funny enough, we're going from where my mate Guion lives, which is Swansea.
Guion the fat man.
Guion the fat-headed fat man, as in Mr. Chairman Custard Creams, all the way to Shrewsbury, which is where our friend Rhys Arnold lives. So I'm basically going from one person's place that I know they live to another. Sorry to have docked my friends, but, you know, no one's going to actually go looking for them, are they? Let's face it. I mean, everyone might go looking for Guion, actually, because Guion's, you know, he's been on telly, don't you know?
Going to rob Guitec.
Yeah.
Take over his company.
Oh, I forgot about this. I've got to turn my game volume down.
Doof.
Not that. I forgot that Rick just will blow off forever and ever. So, GWR2857 in the chat says, morning all. Good morning. Hope you enjoy this run. Oh, hello. Hey! Look, the sun's rising, so you can see the shadow dropping down the side of Rick. Look at that.
How about that?
How about that? In fact, I want to come out here and watch this.
Tom, I've discovered a bug.
I discovered something as well, which is that you're Belen. Anyway, what?
So, the small ejector on the Kings, it's an object, right? You can move it. But it's stuck.
Well, that doesn't sound like a me problem. That sounds like something that you've got that's an issue.
It's permanently stuck open.
Oh, look at that. Like, the sun's just literally revealing Rick. Oh. Lovely jubbly. We love to see it.
Stupid fat thing.
Oi, he's not stupid or fat. He's just big boned. He's just big boiled. Oh, I do like driving him, though, to be fair. I haven't driven him for a little while, so it'd be nice to actually drive him on a proper race as well. And we get this lovely reveal of the sun rising, and we get to see our big man in all in glory. I don't know if anybody's actually watching the live stream. Well, we've got apparently four people watching, which is probably just us. I don't know how the audio levels sound. Hopefully it's all okay. Even though I've got my train sim volume at like one. But either way, hopefully it's fine. Regardless then, my fire is basically up to where I want it. Fat man is blowing off. We have revealed our big man. And we just need to work out what everyone else is driving. I know Liam's driving a king. I think Kobe's driving...
Duke of Gloucester.
James?
I've changed my mind. I'm not driving the A3. I'm driving the King as well.
Hey, and I think Interpret, who is joining us at Newport, he's driving what?
An N15.
Oh.
A 1015? Yeah, what's that? Is that a counter?
An N15.
Oh, N15, sorry. I thought... Okay, N15. All right, then, cool. All right, well, in that case, are we basically ready to go?
Right, it's ready.
Right, Interpret, you did the countdown today then.
Okay. 3, 4, 2, 1, go.
I've got to move backwards first and connect to my train.
Power, etc.
There we go, we're good.
Question is, how long until my game crashes?
Yeah, and mine.
I give it at least 30 seconds.
At least.
Holy fuck, this thing is a rocket.
Yep. Any brakes on?
I think I just managed to get the correct route after all that. Oh, well. No, you're doing guys very
quickly. Oh, well.
I'll start a few minutes later. I'm going to be the last one finished, definitely.
Did you happen to install the King update that CW sent out?
I don't think I have.
Interesting. Okay. Because it reworks the entire simulation, but the thing is, I didn't install it either. So it basically nerfs the King, but we're both on the same one, so that's fine.
Well, how fast are you going then?
55.
You say really? It's nerfed, you're doing 55 and I'm only doing 40.
No, I'm saying I didn't install it.
Oh.
I was just checking if you did.
See, I'm only doing 42.
I'm doing 39.
In fairness, I am kind of technically driving Rick illegally because he hasn't got any overhead warning stickers. He has got a high lamp though, so whether that counts or not, I don't know.
Meanwhile, me with my full 1925 stock.
Am I on a gradient? Oh yeah, we are.
Yeah. 1 in 37? Go away.
Passing Bristol Castle, which is just sitting in the yard.
Okay, maybe I did overcook this idea a little bit. I think I'm probably going to get whipped into the ground by a pair of kings.
It's not too late to restart.
Nah, do you know what? I'm going to take Rick. I don't really mind that much, to be fair. I like driving Rick anyway, so it's nice to take him for a long run over a long route anyway.
I didn't want to take the King, but to be fair, every time we have set out, or I have set out in the King to do this sort of run over Welsh Marches or South Wales Coastal, my game has crashed, or my engine has crashed, or something has gone wrong. I've never actually managed to complete it, so...
I just thought of something else that might be interesting, actually. Has this route got permanent AWS?
I think it does, yes.
Will that hit me, even though Rick hasn't got AWS?
Yes, it does. We figured it out. It does.
So I'm going to die.
It doesn't matter if he doesn't have it.
Remember that race we tried to do last time from Shrewsbury where we all got ghosted?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. So I'm probably going to get killed. I'm going to have to constantly press Q all the way, aren't I?
Yeah, we did at one point, the three of us, we did our... what's it called? Southern. Oh, what's it called? The one to Exeter and from Victoria.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, that one.
We tried that in pre-grouping locos and we still got hit with it. The only difference is we couldn't see it. Not that it mattered.
Well, I'll see how far I get. If I do get AWS ghosted, like, you know, quite badly, then. I may restart with something with AWS. I'd like to actually do this run. I don't know, but...
And AWS just went off and I clicked it, so... It should be fine.
I'm going to keep an eye out for where the AWS ramps are. And see whether I need to press. But it'd be nice to actually drive Rick, like I said, on a long run for a change.
Meanwhile, the engine I have is... King Edward III. Is that preserved?
Maybe.
Don't think it is.
No, it's not.
Cool. The only ones that are preserved are 6000, 6023, and 6024.
What about GWR 6029?
Thrown in the bin.
You're funny, Liam.
Ironic. I know I am, James. Thank you.
Well, I'm doing 60 miles an hour.
Nice.
And I suppose you guys are doing like 70 or 80, aren't you?
Not quite. Fucking 55.
What are you in?
Duke of Gloucester. The prehistoric IHH one.
Prehistoric and it's not even good.
Yes.
I tried that yesterday. It's shit.
It takes an absolute... I forgot about this. It takes an absolute age to
get
any kind of speed going.
It's absolutely rapid, but you have to sacrifice like the entirety of your boiler pressure. If you keep it in the green, it goes up like one tick every like minute.
Yeah, it takes forever to increase reducing speed right now.
Oh, I might need to slow down here. That's quite bad. Oh god, I'm slowing down. Woo!
Well, I haven't been AWS yet, so...
Neath curve. Don't know what
that bright green one version of the Duke you were playing around with, code, was that included in the thing that Tom sent us?
Yes, it is.
Hey, you know how I'm live streaming, boys?
Oops, sorry.
Basically,
it's just one of an old reskin.
It's just a reskin that we found.
Yeah.
Okay.
But it's still something that Jordan made, so I'd rather... I mean, I'll speak to Jordan about it, but... It's very old. I think Jordan's working on a new version of it anyway, so it's fine.
It'd just be great if there was just a new model of this, just period.
We'll just talk to BMG and be like, yo, I know you wanted 10 grand for it, but... Don't you think that's a bit excessive? Right, okay, I've got up to speed. I'm now doing 77 at the moment. Bear in mind I'm in a big 482, so that's interesting. I also don't know what the curvature's like.
Well, there's a 35 limit coming up.
There is indeed a 35 limit.
That's definitely faster than... It should be going, I think.
Should I be worried about the Neath curve?
I took it at about 80.
Maybe I'll ease off a little bit then.
There was some squealing, no tipping though, so...
If, as long as you did 420 no-scope...
Would have been death.
GWR... 2857 chat says the audio's fine, so that's fine.
2857, it's 2800.
Right, this is the moment of truth. Do I get AWF'd in Fat Man? I mean, I haven't yet. It could work. I don't know. We'll see how far we get. But I think I'll probably just try and complete the whole run anyway, even if this is a race. Because I do intend to do another long run at some point with another train. Up the West Coast main line. Well, I went through here at 84 miles an hour, by the way, Liam.
I'm just going to take a phone call.
Okay. Well, I meant to get through at 84 miles an hour, so...
I'm nearing it at 80.
Just cruising at 81, entering the curve now.
I don't know where Liam is, like, in regard to distance. He's been through Neath, though, hasn't he, so...
I'd say so, yeah.
Yeah.
He's made it through the curve.
Yeah, he's probably going to win, to be fair, but it'll be fine. It'll be weak. Right. I need some more coal.
Okay, we've made it past the curve.
Alright, throttle up.
I was just trying to work out why my boiler pressure was plummeting. Auto fireman was going and pumping in a ton of water. Oops.
Have you told the auto fireman to, like, have you said, can you not?
No. Down at 150 PSI. Supposed to be up at like 175.
GWR 2857 in chat. We've only got 10 bogeys at the moment. We've got, in fact, let me just... So you got Rick. Then you got Mark one, Mark two support, and then nine Mark ones. Not a long rake, but considering what we're doing and the amount of hills we're going to have to climb, I think that's fair.
I'm just going to BRB for just 60 seconds or so.
Okay. And so they're dropping like flies already. So, James.
So, Tom.
How many people have you eaten today?
6,002.
Nice. That's very good. I like to hear it. By the way, just so everyone knows, it's New Year's Eve. I mean, I'm pretty sure everybody and their uncles know that it's New Year's Eve. So this is the last thing I'm doing for the new year. For 2023. This is the last thing. On my YouTube channel, the last thing we've done is release another episode of Northwestern. And on Twitch, this is probably going to be the last thing I do this year, which is this race. So I guess this is probably the right time to say, well, I hope everybody had a nice 2023. And here's to 2024. We'll see what happens in the new year. Maybe this Twitch stuff will take off. Maybe I'll actually get back into the groove for doing some work for YouTube. We shall see. But overall, hope everyone has a happy new year. And I hope nobody gets too bladdered tonight. Because you guys are ahead of me, aren't you, James? You lot are ahead of me.
Yeah. That's what I was saying earlier. There are fireworks going off outside.
Yeah, so that means that your new year is going to start, I'm trying to remember.
In 2 hours, actually.
Yeah, because it's 10 p.m. where you are. It's 9 a.m. here.
Yep.
By the way, how fast is everyone going?
You're only doing 84.
I'm climbing a hill.
I don't know about Liam and Kobe.
Sit rep, lads. Yeah. I have been hit by an invisible AWS.
I've been hit by AWS. Sorry. So how fast are you now going, Liam? Zero?
40.
Oh, okay.
I'm just starting back up again.
Okay. Where was that? Like, your mileage? Where was that mileage roughly?
It's about 139.
Okay. I think I just caught the AWS you were talking about.
I was on the phone, but I'm fairly sure it was invisible. Maybe I'm wrong. Because I didn't see it.
Was it going through, was it going through Port Talbot?
It was just before Port Talbot.
Right, well, I've got good news for everybody. It looks like I'm not getting AWS'd.
Ah. So have you gone over that then, James?
Yeah.
Yeah, I've gone through to Port Talbot as well.
From Port Talbot.
I'm doing 90 at the moment. I've passed through Port Talbot just. Okay, let me tell you then. I've got 138 miles to go.
139.1.
So you're a mile behind me.
139.63. However, because of the AWS, I'm just having to start again.
What about you, Liam? What's your distance?
I was 0.3 behind you. I'm now rapidly.
Yeah, but what's your distance as of this very second in time?
137.8.
Every Port Talbot.
Okay, cool. I'm ahead then. Doing 91.
Yeah.
This is where I could potentially get a bit more of a head start. So when you lot start catching me later on, because obviously Rick's top speed is only like 90 something, whereas you lot can do like 100, I think.
Not very far from the speed I was at before.
Come on, fat man. You've got to remember at Newport, we have got to slow down.
Yeah.
Platform 4, yeah?
Yeah, because of the weight curve. Because the alternative at Newport was that we would have to go over a load of crossovers to go through a certain platform to cross back over again. Where we're going round the other way that I've set up, we don't have to go any crossover, but there is a sharper curve at the end of the platforms at Newport. I just think that's a better sacrifice.
I'll take your word for it.
Okay. God, I do like Rick still. I'm glad I've got him. He's a good boy.
He's precious.
He is.
You know what I wish I had?
A jar of dirt?
The A3s to take on this run.
Jar of dirt.
And then other than a jar of dirt. Wish I had the BMG castle.
Why haven't you got the BMG castle?
Because I'm poor.
Have you tried
Sydney, Australia, folks?
Have you tried robbing a bank?
Not of yet, but I'm Australian, so it probably won't take me very long.
It probably wouldn't take too much effort.
I would just go and rob Cobb.
Oh.
You really won't.
What you gonna do about a hammer?
We finally passed Fort Talbot.
Really?
Guy W. West. So I had to start again. And this takes age to speed up.
What's your speed now, Tom?
I'm still doing 90. I'm dropping a little bit, though. Okay. Rick Boyle pressure coming down a little bit.
What's your speed, Liam? Limit.
92.
What's your distance?
134 dead.
You're about 0.9 behind me.
I'm 134.6.
Is it 0.9?
I am 4 miles behind all of you.
Yikes.
I
have to inject on this hill. It's not great.
So here's a question for the for the very small amount of people probably watching in the chat. Who would you like to see to win? Would you like to see Liam winning his king? Would you like to see James winning his king? Would you like to see Kobe make the world's best comeback and winning Duke of Gloucester? Or, of course, would you like Fat Man to win? And Rick, because I'm fat.
You've got a comment, by the way, from VC Context. Reese says, you must stop at Pontypool and Newin. He has a bacon sandwich ready for you.
Well,
so if I stop at Pontypool and New Inn, I will get a bacon sandwich, legit. Is that legit?
Which gives you plus 20 miles an hour average speed.
Right, okay. I tell you what, if I've got enough of a lead on anybody, I will stop at Pontypool and New Inn. Otherwise, Reese is going to have to launch this sandwich off the platform and into the cab of Rick.
Travelling bacon sandwich service.
Yeah, just get a big net out the side of his cab. Oh, goodness, my speed is being eliminated by this incline. I'm at 77 miles an hour.
I'm at 81.
Down to 13 and still dropping by this incline. I just got everything wrong coming up to it.
Probably now I've got to keep an eye
on speed on this incline, Tom.
Yes, I have. But I'm at the top of the hill now, so I can probably re-increase my speed again. Yeah, I've just hit the top now, so my speed's going back up again.
I'm going past Stormy Upline.
I think I've passed it just. The 75 limit, beyond that, I'm at 1.1 from.
On my map, yeah, it's on my map now, 1.6 off mile.
Right, come on, Rick. I need to try and keep pace ahead of the Kings. Not that he cares, he's just happy to be taking part in a race. He's so humble, it's unreal. I love him to bits. He's just like...
Finally getting out of the DR.
Yeah, he's just out on the main line. He's just like, I couldn't care less if I win a race. I just want to take part. It's like, oh, I just want to give you a big cuddle, you big, great lummox.
what if he gets consumed one day?
By what?
By his inner Bob.
Oh, I hope not. I really don't want that to happen. He's basically just like a gentle giant. He's like Warrior from Tugs. Like, even more so than Warrior from TDRS.
Oh, okay. I just realised something.
What?
I can catch the AWS, but it doesn't appear on the F4 HUD.
Interesting.
I can only hear the sound.
You hear the bell, you just need to spam Q.
That's what was going on last time. I didn't hear the sound. But I was confused because usually I can see it on the F4 hub.
Oh.
But this time I'm listening. I'm the fucking 420 Blazer down this hill.
420 Blazer St. Michael? GWR2057 says, although I'm a GWR man, I'd like to see Rick win. I mean, so would I, but...
Would I?
But then again, a king is probably ideal for this run. Especially when you're in regard to speed. Because let's face it, I don't think Rick's got the top speed these guys have.
Could have taken a castle if there was a CW or a BMG castle that I have.
Oh, that's unfortunate. Anyway, last week... Right, how are we doing?
I'm only past bridge end, Tom.
Sorry?
I'm only past bridge end.
Well, I'm 0.3 from it, so I'll tell you in a sec. Hold on. I'm also going to want a speed check off you. Right, okay, so I am going through bridge end platform now, doing 92 0.5. Miles an hour. What are you doing, Liam?
I'm 0.3, I'm doing 99.
Right, so you have definitely got the speed advantage. Well, my only advantage could be, if Fat Man isn't getting caught by AWS, is that he may be able to... If I don't know whether you guys will get caught again, but potentially he might be able to skip the Phantom AWS's, but we'll just have to wait and see. It's early days yet, to be fair.
Mm.
I don't really care about it, but I think it is a little bit stupid that Rick can go that fast.
Yeah, it is. To be fair, in reality, his top speed would probably be more something like 65-70. But this is actually probably why he's not got the low speed torque he should have, which is that he's got more for speed. So it's more so I can drive him on longer distance runs like this. Does that make sense?
Oh, that's fair enough.
Because if I'm stuck to like 70, I'd get really fed up really easily.
And one thing I would sort of mention is because of the size of the driving wheels, would that sort of make him more of an express goods type than a heavy goods?
Yeah.
Hmm.
He's more express goods, which is interesting because really the DR really cocked up with his design, if we're honest. Because, well, not his design, obviously, because Rick's design in general is perfect for the preserved DR. What I mean is, his predecessor design is actually kind of really stupid for the work it was intended to do, which is that Lord Dark wanted to have an engine that could do, what, 1,000 tons up a 1 in 37 without any assistance. Yet he chose an engine with 5'7" driving wheels.
Yeah,
and 4 cylinders at first, and a big high-pressure boiler. So, you know... I mean,
I wonder who came up with him.
I don't know.
He's been quite stupid.
He must have been an actual bellend. Well, I mean, there was another proposal from North British to build a 282, a bit like the P1s. But Lord Dark was like, no, I'm dead set on a 482. He really wanted a standard gauge mountain type because no other company had built one for the UK market. And he was really inspired by the... Because I think within the 77C universe, the Romney Hive and Dymchurch Railway still exists. So we would have had Samson and Hercules still exist. Because I think they've been mentioned before anyway. I think David Eddy had mentioned it. But either way, so as the Romney exists, that does mean that there is actually some inspiration from them for their wheel arrangement, seeing as there's no other 482s standard gauge on the UK network in 77C. As far as we're aware of. Because that's why he's like the unique, quote-unquote, unique mountain type on the UK network. So maybe 90 miles an hour isn't such a bad speed, actually, but that would be his absolute operate. That would be a bit like with the 9Fs, because remember, the 9Fs could do 90 on express passenger.
Yeah.
And they've got smaller drivers. Oh, no, it wasn't.
Really?
Yeah. Mm. Evening Star, I think, was clocked at 92.
Evening Star, all sorts of trouble for it.
Yeah, because they were like, the reciprocating forces would do more damage to the engine if it was running at that speed constantly.
Mm.
So, it is feasibly possible to have Rick with his 5'7" compared to... What's a 9F driving wheels? 5 foot?
4'5" or something.
They're very small, aren't they?
Hmm.
Either way, so actually, when we think about it, actually 90 is probably realistic as Rick's maximum top speed, but in practice, he would never really run at this speed. By the way, I have dropped speed again, Liam, speaking of speed, I'm at 71. So, what's your distance total?
5 foot diameter driving wheels.
5 foot, was it? Liam, what's your distance now?
120.3.
Yeah, you're if you're going faster than me, which I think you are, because I'm doing 70.
I'm doing 81 at the moment.
Yeah, you've overtaken me then.
My distance is 126, but I'm got a bit of speed going. I'm doing 102 now.
You might be able to claw some of this back.
And from what I can see, it's pretty happy at 102 on this level gradient.
Right, that's good news for you then.
Yeah.
Right, well, I've just gone through whatever this station is. Lanharan? So I presume Liam is ahead of me now.
As you said that, my tail coach went through it.
Yeah, you're probably ahead of me then. Because I'm only up to 76 at the moment. 77 I've just hit.
No, I'm gunning it down the cell, I'll tell you that.
Now, I mean, it'd be a good time to mention, like, comment, and subscribe. Even though I'm not even on YouTube streaming at the moment. It's on Twitch, so follow on Twitch. And use the emojis that you can use on Twitch. For example, I'm going to use another one again. Because I've got...
emoji.
Yeah, I've got custom emojis on Twitch now, so I can do the smug face, for example. Gives you more of an incentive to look at Twitch. I don't know how I can add any more. I've got 4 of them at the moment. I might try and add a 5th one at some point. Oh, I'm up to 86. Come on, fat man. Oh, I don't like these new headphones. I bought some new headphones yesterday, and they're sort of, I think they're noise-cancelling ones, so I can. Everything feels really muffled. Like, my own voice is muffled through the headphones. So I don't know how loud
I'm
speaking.
Take them back, mate.
No, don't get me wrong. They're fine. They're fine for me. They'll probably be fine for me video editing and stuff, because they were much louder than the old one, but... they'll do for now. I just really needed a new set of headphones because my old ones were falling apart. So these are what I saw. These are what I fancied. So that's what I bought. Just luck of the draw, innit? What you get.
Mm-hmm.
Plus, they weren't that expensive, to be fair. So, and I don't buy myself very much very often. So. Right. Okay. We're doing 88 miles per hour. And we've got 108, yeah, basically 116.8 miles to go. Not bad. Just depends. Got to keep an eye out for when we get to Newport.
So you're bored?
What?
Did you just say you're bored?
No, I said, I can't remember what I just said. I said 100 something, just, I don't remember what I said.
Oh.
I didn't say I'm bored, I know that. I didn't say I'm bored.
I said I'm bored.
What?
Do you believe me?
No.
I'm really confused. I Liam, just stop.
Liam, be quiet.
Who knows what Liam's talking about?
Quiet, child.
Liam gaslights Tom and other stories.
Always. It does suck that my schedule's all over the place with this, like, the whole live streaming thing, because at the moment, like, it's early in the morning for me, but late at night for you Aussie guys.
It's not that bad.
What I mean is, like, usually if I was streaming, I mean, ideally what I'd like to be able to do is stream in the evening, like, you know.
Like, do both.
Well, I could. I mean, like, not today, but other days, because I'm going to try and speak to my partner and see if she's all right with me doing that. Like, if she comes in from work. But the trouble is, I don't like it when she comes in from work and I'm streaming, and essentially I've got to ignore her because I'm doing something on here. Therefore, that's why I don't like streaming after 8 o'clock at night anymore. Because when she gets home from work, I'd actually like to say, hi, how are you doing? How was work? Go and have a cigarette.
Take
with
a 10-minute break.
I could, I suppose, but sometimes it depends on how busy you are in the middle of things. So, essentially, I don't like doing that, to be honest.
So? You can buy her a bunch of flowers and a nice dinner from the potential money that you might be making from Twitch in the future.
Maybe. I don't know. I mean, I don't know how this sort of... it's weird, right? Because I don't know Twitch very well. I don't know what the audience, like, retention or whatever is like. I obviously imagine that if you stream often, you'll get a following of some description.
So it's quite hard to build a Twitch stream follow base from the ground up, but it helps a lot. You basically get a head start if you're a YouTuber before you're a Twitch streamer.
Yeah.
So if you sort of hardcore just advertise on your YouTube and Discord server, eventually the ball will get rolled.
Yeah.
You know, because people on YouTube that usually watch you will move to Twitch.
Yeah. I mean, the thing is like, I just find it so much... It's simpler to just like boot up a live stream and do something random on Twitch than what I normally do on YouTube, which is my audience is at YouTube, but you have to, like, for me anyway, I feel like I have to set up a... I think it's because of me and, like, you know, the way we seem to do things as well, which you have to set up a thumbnail, you have to set up a specific time to go live, you have to set up, you know, what time... you have to advertise it that way. Well, with Twitch, I could just go, I fancy doing a drive on train sim, or at some point, I will look at another game, possibly. I want to at some point. Even if I just do a run-through of Gran Turismo 4 on the old emulator. I'd like to do stuff like that, but I could just go whenever I like on Twitch, whereas on YouTube, I feel like I have to sort of go through a bit of a scheduling thing. And plus, if I schedule a live stream on YouTube... I then, if something suddenly comes up and I can't do it, I have to then go through the whole thing of saying, sorry guys, got to cancel the stream. And then you've got to rearrange it. Which is kind of annoying and unbaked, especially if you can't get on your computer to do that. Is this making sense to anybody?
Yeah.
That's
what I got, you mean.
I think this has happened with Reese before, where... I think this is the exact scenario I'm talking about, actually, where Reese has set up a live stream to do. He's had to turn around and say, sorry guys, I've had to go to work. Like, you know, short notice, but he hasn't been able to get online to cancel the stream, so the stream has been sat there waiting to start from the time it was scheduled to start, and people have been sat there going, oh, when did the stream start, not having seen the previous note. So it's just frustrating for both parties in that respect. Whereas with Twitch, I just go, right, whatever I'm playing at the moment, OBS, load it up, press the go button, and then that's it.
Surely he would have been able to cancel.
I don't think it's that easy, especially if you haven't got a YouTube Studio on your phone, like I haven't got it on my phone either, because I can't be bothered.
It is really
I'd
hard to
it probably takes
you go wrong.
Probably about 30 seconds on the computer.
Yeah.
That's, you've got access to the computer.
Either way, I'd like to grow Twitch a little bit, because I think it would be easier for me. But I do want to actually get... I said the other day, I need to get back into getting YouTube stuff sorted out as well. Because obviously, now I've released Thomas and Train. I now need to... I've only got one episode now ready to go of that. And I still have to write the one after that. So therefore...
Fuck! Why now?
Yes.
What happened?
Did it
crash? Yes.
Oh, you got AWS.
Yes!
I just realized what I'm about to be hearing soon. Cob, I will fucking murder you. Basically, I just realized what I'm about to start hearing. It's New Year's Eve fireworks, which I'm about to start hearing.
Where did that happen, by the way, Liam? Was that
fucking
Ponty Clun?
Just before Canton Depot.
Canton Depot.
Like Cardiff. Isn't that Cardiff?
Yeah, Cardiff Canton.
Cardiff Canton, yeah.
It's a 30 minute.
Are you close to me, Cobb? How fast?
Speaking
are you?
Of, I'm doing 105.
Mileage. Go.
My mileage is 111.9.
Oh, it's
fucking
right.
4 hours
right
behind
ass.
Me. Suck my fucking balls.
Wait, where are you?
I'm 107.
Oh.
Yeah. Loser. Loser.
Well, I am cruising through Canton Depot up Main. Although there's a 20 limit, I really... Yeah? Is there a reason why there's a 20 limit here? Please tell
Canton
me.
Canton Depot please. Up Main. You're ahead of me.
Yeah.
Cough.
Why is there a is there a crossover? Am I imagining things? I'm going to press save just in case.
No, it's just Cardiff is... There's a curve. I know it's Cardiff. It's a station. You have to slow down through a station. That's a big station.
Because I'm going through Cardiff now. Cardiff up main through.
What's his speed, Tom?
87.
Okay, man. Almost 106 now.
Jesus. Where are you going,
106
Toby?
Miles an hour.
109 miles away.
Okay, you're about 4 miles behind me.
Hey?
Well, I'm... Hang on, wait. Let's work this out. I'm at 105.5.
I'm at 109.4.
I'm 108.3.
105.5. You're half a mile ahead of me.
Wait, what's yours now, Liam?
106.5.
Yeah, 105.1. Yeah, you got AWS, didn't you?
Fuck, I didn't realise you're that close to me.
But why is there a 30 limit? Begs
there
a
isn't.
Question.
You don't need to slow down through there. You don't have to slow down through there, boys. I didn't slow down at all.
All right. I'm.
And I've got proof because I'm
going through Cardiff.
I'm going about 87, I think.
Watching for the AWS as carefully as I can.
Fast. 90 speed, I says at the moment.
Speed's a lot, mate.
Fuck, for the 10 seconds that I was out of my fucking window.
I just want to just chat for a minute, guys, sorry. Cookie... Oh, God, how do you pronounce the name? Cookie iOS Woosh, I think their name is, said they're late. And Jordan said Big Rick and Spoons for some reason. Okay. And obviously, Reese has said about stopping a, Yeah. I'm not going to stop there. I'm just going to have to use the pickup device that I've magically put on Rick's side. To be fair, Liam...
He's got me up his ass.
To be fair, Liam, I am... How fast are you going?
77 now.
Oh, okay. Never mind then. I'm doing 90.
I'm nearing Cardiff, the 20 limit. I'm nearing it at 105.
I'm going for Cardiff now.
Hey!
That curve. Oh.
It's fine. It's fine. Honestly, guys, it's fine. It's Newport I am slowing down for. I don't give a shite. I am slowing down at Newport no matter what.
Okay.
I'm not risking it through those platforms.
Here we go, through the 20 limits. Oh, wait, not yet.
Go on, Colin.
104. Wait.
What,
no.
What happened? What happened? What happened?
We're just still alive.
Ooh. This is Kobe's redemption arc, hopefully.
This is...
Yeah.
If I'm beating my cop, I will hang up the fucking... Hang up the
you'll
belt.
You'll stop shit-talking a bit for a while, for one.
Yeah.
I'll hang up the belt. The champion belt that I have.
God, look at this lad go. I'm sure his valve gear would be knocked to bits in reality. Because he's
probably.
Right. 101.2 miles to go. On the flat doing 91. That's not too bad, to be fair. How are we doing for all of our other bits? Might need to put some more. Might need to put some more fire in, Nicole. Well, at least we ain't got to go through comp buying today. Well, I'm enjoying this race. How about everyone else?
I'm going to run out of water.
I was quite... I will admit, I was getting very frustrated earlier, but now that catastrophe has befallen Liam, it's suddenly become much better.
You are so... You Kobe, right? You and Liam are the worst people to race against.
Listen,
you two are so
catastrophe,
competitive.
Catastrophe can befall me as many times as it wants to. I will still win.
He says,
and
hurries
from
Tom's
the yard.
In front.
Yeah, but Liam would just claim I'm cheating, even though I've been going slower than him most of the way.
No, you're not cheating. I have just been befuddled by misery and
pain. I've been drugged by an AWS.
I blame the fucking fireworks in my distance for distracting me.
I blame society.
Thank you, fireworks people.
Kobe, stop being so vindictive!
Cookie, oh, come on, it's good entertainment.
This is entertainment.
The island of man.
Oh, what's it called? He's my rival.
Hang on, let's try that again. Right, Liam, say again.
Oh, yeah, I just said Kobe's my rival.
And interpret, say again.
Cookie iOS Whoosh said we need the Isle of Man Steam Railway in Train Simulator Classic.
Oh, do you know what? I'd love that. I'd actually really like that, to be honest.
Isle of Man Steam.
Yeah, the Isle of Man Steam Railway.
It's a half the island.
It's like 3 foot gauge, I think, or 3 foot 6 inch gauge, I think. It's really cool though. They use like these little 240 tank engines. It's really cool. God, this is the racetrack, by the way, between Cardiff and Newport. It's just a big straight line.
Yeah.
So if you guys have got a higher top speed than me, then you lot are going to blaze past me, I reckon. Because I'm stuck at 91.
Where are you, James?
I am currently 100.5 miles.
What about you, Kobe?
102.8.
97.2.
How fast are you, Kobe?
I'm doing 91.
Oh, so we can match that speed.
Slowed a little earlier.
Oh, shoot, where are we? Hang on. Oh, right, hang on. We're approaching Newport now, so I need to think about slowing down as soon as I see the platform markers.
I need to start concentrating.
Quick, Co, fire off some more fireworks.
I'll launch them from all the way over here.
Huh. Launch them inside his house.
Right, I will brake when I get to the tunnel, I've decided. We shouldn't get crossovers or anything. Actually, that's probably going to be a bit too late.
No, I'm not. We're slipping going up this hill at the moment.
You're going to break when you get to the tunnel.
Yeah.
Mate, you are in the thick of it by the tunnel.
To be fair, I reckon I get around it about 60-odd miles an hour, so that's all I'm going to go down to. Maybe a little bit less.
I'm just like our advanced scout right now.
Yeah. Right. Okay, I have slowed down a lot, to be fair.
I see the 75 limit.
Oh, shit.
You know what, Tom? I think you're wrong, actually.
Why?
I think taking the crossover at Newport would have been a better idea.
Too late to change it now.
That's true, yeah.
Right, I'm going to save it just here, just in the very...
Have you passed the 60 limit? You have.
Yeah, I'm just coming into the platform now.
Oh, okay. At what speed?
I'm doing 51. I didn't want to risk it in the end.
About to hit the tunnel doing 85.
Oh, cute.
Right.
Cool, that was close.
Okay, the curve is a bit scary, but I got through it at 53, so now I can put back on the power. Come on, Rick, let's go. Let's get out of here.
Fuck.
Oh, actually, saying that, what's the curve here? Oh, no, the curve here is absolutely fine, I reckon. Right, okay, we should be golden from here, I hope. Save again. I'm so terrified.
Okay, there's the platform, shutting the throttle.
I can see a 75 limit.
Doing it at 65. Holy fuck.
Where's the tunnel? Where's the tunnel? Where's the tunnel? Where's the tunnel? There's the tunnel. Brakes.
can see the 60 limits.
Oh my god, what about the curve? Fuck, how fast are you going on the curve? 53 as well.
What, in the platforms?
No, the triangle.
Oh, I went round there like a million.
Yeah,
you're not there yet, are you?
I'm going around the triangle now, yeah.
Oh, shit.
Fucking hell. Liam, where are you?
I'm going around the triangle.
What, so you're at Newport now?
I'm through Newport.
No way.
Shit.
No
what?
Way. How?
What do you mean?
There is no way. What's your distance right now?
93.4.
How the fuck?
How did you do that?
I went through the platforms at 65.
You mad lad.
Did you catch up that quickly? What the fuck?
Yeah, what?
What do you mean catch up? You two were never ahead of me.
Yeah, they were.
No, yeah. Only you, Tom.
I'm sure they were ahead of you.
Yeah.
No.
Okay.
I don't think so, at least. I might be wrong.
I think...
Who fucking cares, Cobra's score?
I agree with you on that one.
I'm going to say, just 420 blaze it from this point onwards.
He's using a HST.
So you see, we've got the Super 47.
Okay, we're going to try the Newport at about 62, I reckon.
I am, after all, a professional. Fuck, this thing is drinking water. Holy shit.
How much water you got left?
Suddenly.
2,500 gallons.
Oh, I've still got 4,000.
Yeah, but
I've got I've got 2,660.
Oh, yes. Come on, Rick. Come on, boy.
Isn't this like a 4,000-gallon tender?
Yeah.
5,000-gallon tender.
Is it?
No, unless you're talking about
Rick. Call it tender.
Oh, call it tender. Yeah, it's 4,000. No, it's 4,000.
I've used 1,500 gallons in like 40 miles.
Yeah, well, I've used 1,500 gallons as well, nearly.
I've used 900.
Usually, 100 miles is about 3,500 gallons.
Must have gone the wrong way because I'm just fighting hills the whole entire time.
There's hills going up the Welsh Marches.
Yeah, that's what I'm fighting.
Yeah.
I don't even know if I'm going to have enough water.
One in 95.
I've made it past the triangles.
Okay, Tom, so what's your mileage?
My mileage right now is 90 dead.
Ooh, 0.5.
What, behind me? How fast are you going?
AC 5.
Yeah, you can catch me on the hills for some reason.
I'm having problems getting back up to 90 then.
See, my trouble is I have to put Rick into his lowest reverser setting, anything above 65 miles an hour. Therefore, I can't put any power down, otherwise I'd just start slowing down.
That's a bit stupid.
Yeah.
Interesting, Chris.
No, that's my fault. I think I've modified something somewhere along the line.
My bad, Chris.
As I say, you'll probably catch me on these inclines anyway. Well, we're nearly halfway there. Halfway would be
better of the king, honestly.
How far would halfway be, actually? 150 odd miles is 75 miles would be the halfway point, wouldn't it?
Yeah.
We've been joined by Guion. We've recently left your place of living.
Hello, Guion.
Hello.
Hello, said Guion. Sounding very happy as usual.
Hello. Hello, said the man who lives in Swansea.
I'm very tired.
So, Gwyn, how are you?
Tired.
You're tired, say?
Yeah, I was out last night, so.
Oh, were you getting hammered?
I don't drink.
Oh.
You don't drink?
How sad.
I don't drink.
Gwyn.
Don't Gwyn me.
Gwyn.
You.
Look, he was looking after his body. He's all right. He's fine.
Don't worry, Guion. I'll make up for your lack of drinking by drinking more.
How does that even work?
It just does.
It doesn't. Logic doesn't matter when you're drunk.
Oh, God. I'm only doing 66 from Cumbran. I'm not, well, not even through Gumbran. I'm like 0.2 from it. But that does mean I might be able to move my reversal up in a minute.
Oh, what's your distance?
90.9. 90.1. What was that, James?
90 miles now.
I'm 0.6 from you then.
Liam, did you say you've 70? Liam, did you say you've been through Cumbran?
Yes.
Yeah, you've overtaken me again then. Kind of tense, actually, this, isn't it?
A bit, yeah.
Although, to be fair, I think if Liam didn't keep getting AWS, he'd be miles and miles ahead of me by this
you
point.
You say that, but I seem to be making a sort of thing out of it. It seems to always happen to me. I am usually faster, but I come across sorts of problems that keep me back. With Cobra, remember that one race with the
don't
two...
Yeah,
oh, what were they? Two Grangers.
Yeah.
It's like that.
Ha!
I was just really salty at this point.
Who is you?
What?
Cobe.
Oh, Cobe, yeah.
What? What am I? What?
You're salty because Liam's ahead of you again. Well, not again. He was always ahead of you, but your opportunity has disappeared.
Again.
Trouble is, I bet the audience are all like...
Big balls.
Trouble is, the audience probably all want Rick to win, but...
are we streaming?
Yes, I'm on Twitch.
Yes.
Damn it.
What, do you not want to be on... Gwil, you've been on television. Fuck off. You'd love to be
Nah,
on...
it's just I can't swear certain words.
Yeah, you can. You can say, fuck, shit, wank, bollock, cunt.
How many viewers do you have
that?
Yeah, I don't give a fuck. I've put it down as vile language, so who cares?
Can I say racial slurs?
Nope. Not allowed to say the N-word at all. Like, that will get you instantly banned from my server as well.
Lol.
How many viewers have you got, Tom?
I don't know. Hang on, let me look. We've got 7 people watching of 125
right, okay.
Following.
Reese, I don't know if you're still watching, but the victor is about to go through Pontypool and Newin, so I'll take that bacon sandwich, thank you.
Yeah, I'm 0.6 behind you then if you're going through Pontypool and Newin. But that is the top of the incline,
Tom.
So... Hello? What?
Hey, Tom.
What?
You say I'm vindictive and cocky. How's that Liam kid?
Oh, you bastard.
That Liam kid
give
is a twat.
He's saving it for you, Tom. He didn't give it to me.
Where's he putting this? I can't see it. Where's he putting this information?
No, I'd literally just made that up.
Oh, okay. So he didn't give it to you. He's giving it to me. All right. Well, we're doing 65 miles an hour. So I reckon, 55 miles an hour. So I reckon he could probably chuck it at me.
It's going to give you a power boost, and it's going to give you the... Through the power of friendship, you're going to win.
Yeah, well, thanks, Reese. Cheers, mate! And now the speed is increasing as we go through Pontypool. Let's go. He can give me a bacon sandwich. I've now got the energy I need to continue my journey.
Feed it to Rick through his firebox.
Yes. I will chuck it into his firebox.
Use me as fuel to beat Hammond.
What will?
Hammond.
Said, use me as fuel to beat Hammond.
Yeah. Hammond!
Pretty much.
Hammond, you blithering idiot!
You reversed into the reverser!
Use your mirrors, Hammond!
Hello, the train guy in chat, by the way. And I would have read everything else that's been said, but...
mirrors! God, that special was something else.
GWR2857 reckons I should have taken the T14 instead. No fucking way would that have won. I'm sorry.
That'd still be in the first place.
Yeah, that would still be at Swansea, broken down because something's happened because it's a Drummond design. Right, I'm up to 80 miles an hour. Come on.
I didn't realise that you could do a Swansea to Cumbran.
You can do Swansea to... We're doing Swansea to Shrewsbury. Because it's the combination of the South Wales Coastal and Welsh Marches. Hang on, let me show you the map, Will. Look.
They're actually combined. Hang
yeah,
on,
look.
I'm going to have to actually go into your stream.
You, why are you watching already, Gwion?
I'm watching Liam's stream on here. On
well, watch
Discord.
On Twitch!
That's right, baby.
I am,
well,
a better stream.
Well, tell me when you're on there and I'll put the map back up. Right, you're on there. Okay, look, so there's Swansea, yeah? You've got all the line down to there and you've got all the line up there.
I'm just waiting for the stream to catch up.
Well, we'll probably catch up in a sec. I'm going back to the map. I'm going back to my train anyway. because I need to check my water. I need water.
I'm assuming it goes all the way to
Shrewsbury.
Bristol.
Yeah, going down to Bristol as well, yeah.
So is it a map merge?
Yeah, just the merge. It's just the merger.
Oh, neat.
Yeah. What we're hoping they're going to, what the GAD guys are going to do with Dorset Coast, Somerset and Dorset when that's built, and West of England.
Mergers.
Yeah, mergers.
Mergers are basically futuristic technology for today.
The trouble is with doing mergers, though.
I can't even believe that we can do them.
The trouble with doing mergers, though, is they have to line up with the geometry. When you set a location, or when you first build the route template, when you very first build the route, you have to bear in mind where that is. Because if you do it correctly and accurately, you can merge routes together if they've got the correct geometry.
So basically, they both have to be done properly.
Yeah, but I think, you know, these two routes must have been, I think, because this was the Bothman Games route, wasn't it, the Welsh
yep.
Marches? So he must have actually worked out where his the actual point of merging would be. In order
good job,
to build
Bossman Games.
So whatever he did a good job making it like that. So well done. Liam, how fast are you going?
Doing 101.
Yeah, I'm only doing 93. God damn it.
Sorry, yeah.
Rick. You're just not going to beat them, mate. I'm sorry, mate. But he's still happy as Larry. He's just still happy to be part of the race. So, all right, Rick. If you're happy with it, Rick, then you so be it. He just wants to travel. He's just enjoying the journey.
I hope Bossman makes another route one day. Cough.
I thought you said, I hope Bossman Games makes another Rick one day.
No.
I wonder if he
would. I
would
love to see that.
I would love to see that.
I would love to see Chris's face if you decide to
Big
do that.
Big Bob Advance Mode.
Big Bob Advance Mode, yeah. Except this time he's got an opening smoke box door that actually killed people. No,
right.
I don't know. I mean, I don't know. It would be cool to see something
rep.
Like that. Yeah, go on then. I've got 79 miles to go.
I have 77.3.
Yeah, so you're about 2 miles ahead of me now. But that's because...
I'm 82 miles.
So you're only about
James?
3 miles behind me. Yeah, James?
I am at the back now.
Oh.
With what mileage?
82.7.
Only a little bit, though.
Big Bob, when
punching
he smacks his AC class with his advanced opening smoke box door.
Yeah, opening smoke box door, real-time damper animation, real-time cheese-eating animation.
Oh, that'd be Pog.
Tom likes his cheese.
I do like cheeses. I've been asked in chat... what are my thoughts on the M7? I like Big 53, as in 3.0053 at Swanage. 2.45 is pretty neat as well, because it's a short frame version. M7s are cool. I think they actually lasted like fairly longer than they should have, really, in service. But they're cool. Because interestingly, I actually find it interesting that technically you could count the two M7s that are in preservation as two completely separate classes. Because you've got the short frame version and the long frame version, which technically are separate classes according to the build sheets. Like, according to their build numbers and everything like that, like their order numbers. Because I think it was only the very first batch of M7s built that were actually batch numbered M7s. Everything else would like X8 and stuff like that. Which is just a little tidbit, I don't know.
Kind of funky like that.
Hmm. I still don't know what my audio level sounds like because of my stupid headphones now. Because I'm trying to get into these stupid headphones.
I think you should take a look at your Twitch, Tom.
I think I should. Oh, hello. I have a new subscriber. And that's you, isn't it, Liam?
Yep.
How? Okay. Oh, it's with Prime. Is that like as in Amazon Prime?
Yes. It's a free thing that you get if you have Amazon Prime.
Okay, cool. That's pretty base.
So I don't know if that gives you the normal amount of money as a sub, which
I have...
is probably like...
I've known
it became very unbusy, but it doesn't matter because I've got Amazon Prime.
Hey, be quiet, go on, your big head.
Oh God, I'm going for Abergavenny, and there's an absolutely gigantic stonking hill coming up. I'm very scared.
I did not go that hill.
Clarkson announcing Grand Tour.
Tom.
Hello, yes.
I can see a 90 limit probably somewhere near Ebergaveni.
Oh, so you're catching up to me. Jeez, yeah, okay.
Yeah, I'm doing 111.
Oh, yeah, no chance I've got then. Sorry, Whoops. Rick, you're about to probably be overtaken again. Sorry, mate. But he's still happy. He's fine. He's loving the fact he's actually having a long journey for a change. God,
who the
I love
hell
this
keeps dropping in and out?
Liam.
Hey. Liam.
Lol, Liam dead.
Ah, hey. Oh, he's lost all of his internet.
And he's back. Well, yeah. Discord is being funky.
So am I.
Haunted Rillas up me?
Oh god, this is a Grimace. 1 in 82. Yeah, oh my god, we are slowing down mega, by the way, everyone.
Oh yeah, it absolutely destroyed me. I was down to 10 for parts of it.
So everyone can point and laugh at this user because this engine potentially should be a really good hill climber and he isn't. I'll tell you what though, Liam, I will say one thing about Rick.
Yeah.
He looks good doing it.
He does good. He does.
Well, you know your burp just interrupted a rather excellent whistle from Rick, right?
Excellent.
Oh.
I have a feeling that Gwyn does not care.
I do have that feeling, you know. I don't know what it was. I don't know whether it's just a general demeanour, but I do think he doesn't give a fuck. Oh, bye then.
Oh, fuck's sakes.
Oh, the server muted guy.
Oh, yeah, because I don't want to hear about any I walked into a door business today, because that's the guy who keeps walking into doors or something.
Well, that was pretty dumb.
Yeah.
Are you being serious?
Yeah, him and Jake Taylor keep having arguments, so I'm just like, no, I'm just fine.
But are you seriously saying this person has been saying they'd be walking into doors?
Yes.
I think he goes to see a doctor.
Is that some kind of bit?
I don't know, Liam, but that's what we said. Anyway, it doesn't matter. Let's just carry on and be happy for a bit. I'll unserve and mute them later. Maybe.
Hey, Tom. Maybe.
Hey, what?
The funniest thing happened today.
Did it? Did you win another race?
No, I fucking walked into a door.
Oh, did you? I thought you were going to say you walked into another AWS.
I walked into another airport and I died.
You walked into an airport and
you
died?
You know, I walked into a door as well, actually.
Did you? Did you?
Yeah, apparently.
I walked through a door once.
Fuck! How'd you manage that?
He opened the big wooden panel thing. He moved that to the side, and then he went through it.
Oh my god! Unreal, right? Unreal. But
you know, it's almost as if that's what they're for.
No, I mean I actually walked through a solid door, Gwil. I walked through one. Do you know why? Because there's a big hole in the middle.
The hole in the middle. It wasn't a solid door then, not bad.
I fucking hate references that I'm getting.
What? Why do you? What reference?
I'm assuming this is a reference.
No.
No.
Oh.
It's just
it really
something
sounds like a reference.
I could give you a reference you will
I'm
understand.
Being a knobhead.
I got a reference you could understand, Liam.
Yeah.
You're a twat. There you go.
I'll give you a reference you can understand.
Go on, then.
Fuck.
Yeah, that was nice.
That was a really good reference, not gonna lie. Such a good reference.
Reach the top
you
of the
know
hill.
What? Gwion, as seen on TV, simnation.com. I'm not going to buy a rail aligner, and there's nothing you can do about it.
Poor story, bro.
Oh, dear. By the way, I topped the bank at about 66 miles an hour. That's not too bad.
I'm going to
I've
come
only just
to Swansea.
Topped the bank, Tom.
Burn down every building.
Tom, did you say you've just topped the bank?
I'm now going down the bank.
What's your distance?
70.5.
You are a mile behind me.
Ah.
I'm only like 9 miles ahead of you by sheer fluke. That hill just absolutely crippled me.
Wait,
did
so
you start when we started from Shrewsbury?
Yeah. Well, wait. Where did you start from, Interpret? And when did you start? When did you start?
Like 2 minutes after you, because I missed it.
I
stuffed up.
Well, I think the idea was for you to start when we got to Newport.
No, I was never going to catch you anyway. I'm in a much slower loco and I'm struggling.
Well, where are you at right now? I'm just curious.
Yeah, I'm curious as well. Where are you?
I'm curious about something.
60 and a half miles to go.
60 and a half?
60. How long is it up to?
So he's like 8 miles ahead of me, but he started at Newport, so it's fine. I'm hoping then that I can at least beat him to Shrewsbury.
I'm pretty sure you will. I'm struggling because I keep running out of boiler pressure and I'm only doing 47.
Is that because you're driving an N15?
Yes.
I'm licking my lips. I cannot wait to take his life.
I'm sorry, what?
That sounds really fucking dodgy, Liam.
Jesus Christ, on a cracker.
Why do we associate with this guy? Tell me again.
It's a good question.
Because I'm funny.
No, you're not.
Sometimes.
So I am.
I think you should explode rapidly, you know?
I think it's like the second time I've ever actually driven the M15, so...
Practice makes perfect. Even better, I've got better advice for you, Interpret, right? Bin the N15, buy T14 if better.
Mm. Yeah. Oh my god, that's a sharp corner.
Is it? What, in Hereford?
Good.
No, I'm not a Hereford.
Hereford.
Just before Pontrilas up Main, there's a sharp corner.
I can't even see that on my map. So
because I'm like 10 miles ahead of you.
Yeah, I gathered that.
I've got a question.
So have I.
On the Welsh Marches line, why are there still semaphore symbols?
Old line. Couldn't be bothered. Hardly used. No one cares about it.
Can't be fucked, mate.
British Rail forgot that it exists, etc., probably.
In modern day?
Yeah. Actually, a heritage railway, didn't you know?
Mate, they've had like 90 years.
Yeah, but didn't you know this is actually just a big heritage railway, Liam? This is the longest heritage railway in Britain.
Mate, every single line in Britain is just a heritage railway because your entire country is a heritage country. That's why you have not gained any culture in the last 100 years.
Excuse me,
I will say, says the guy who actually wants to move to England.
Yes, you've got me there. But I'm also fucking loony.
You are a bit of a bell as well, aren't you, to be honest?
Bit of a bell, but you're my end, so we're a bell end together.
Very nice. One day I'll do one of these races against Liam and I'll win comfortably with some sort of, a meaningful victory rather than Liam storming ahead.
Someone wake Tom up.
Crushing him between your
ass
cheeks.
Someone wake the old man up. He's fallen asleep.
Now he's being old. Now he's calling me old again.
Well, that wasn't the point, but it works.
What's your speed, Liam, by the way?
98 at the moment, 97 planet.
108.
Kobe,
yeah,
I think
like 10 miles behind me.
Kobe, I reckon you're going to overtake me.
Probably.
It's probably
where
just because he's on the massive downhill.
Where are you, Tom?
I'm sat in my house.
Fuck, you know what? So am I.
Alright, Kobe. I am at 63.45. Go through Prontrilis or whatever it's called.
I'm at 66.2.
66.2?
Yes, 66 exactly now.
How are you still 3 miles behind me?
I can see a 70 limit. I don't know otherwise.
Well, I can see clearly now that the rain has gone.
For the moment.
Sunny day!
Hey Liam, can you do me a favour?
Yeah?
Can you have a massive accident, please?
Fuck no. And you couldn't get through either.
Oh yeah, fuck! That would work. Dumbass. Yeah, I've dropped. Whereas you can do like 9,800 miles an hour, I top out about 90, so.
You know what? Hereford is actually my mortal enemy. You know why? Because it's in Wales.
Oh. Well, actually, it isn't.
Is it?
No. Hereford's not in Wales. Hereford's
in England.
Yeah,
Liam has been bamboozled again.
Whatever.
The Welsh march
dips in and out of Wales. Welsh marches can suck my balls.
Okay. Why did you crash
it? Shrewsbury in Wales?
No. It's in Wrexham.
So it's in Wales for like only a little bit.
No. I'm going to burp.
I've got a jar of dirt.
Same.
And you can't have it.
It might be a bit questionable if I sent dirt across to you, dog. Tom.
I mean, I wouldn't mind the jar of dirt right now.
Is it special dirt?
Maybe.
Yummy.
Nah, just random dirt.
It's what we used to smother you with Liam when you arrive at Shrewsbury.
Oof.
Okay, hang on. I've done... like 20 miles since...
How much water have you got left, Liam?
Dude, I've used like 800 gallons in like 20 miles.
Yeah, how much water have you got left?
I've got 1,700.
And how far have you got?
56.
You're 4 miles ahead of me.
I am.
I'm only just ahead of you.
However, if you've only got, what, 1,700, did you say?
Yeah.
That should be enough to finish with.
I've coasted a half of the Great Western Mainline before.
Hashtag humble brag.
Again.
Look, Tom, you started it, okay? You ignited the fire.
Look, I could just throw all of you into a dustbin and it would be fine. Okay?
Mate,
no one would care.
I'd bring you with me.
Yeah, but I'd have to then throw myself into an industrial science dustbin because I'm so fat. In fact, I'm so vast that I might actually end up causing a black hole to occur if I fall off any sort of, like, even a 5 foot drop. I would just cause a black hole to start up. And then everyone would die, and then we would all be very happy. And I would,
This is a 55 limit!
Oh! Screamed the trucks. We want a proper engine, not a red for China.
That's not good. I'm doing 105.
Yeah, Liam's just overtaken me.
I'd like Liam to fall over, because if he falls over, he's lost.
That is why I shall not fall over. Oh my
where
god.
You at,
one did not simply fall over.
Do I risk it? No. But I want to, but no.
Herbie?
Oh, yeah.
Where are you at?
59.4.
Yeah, you're well ahead of me.
You're about 2 miles behind me now, Kobe, so you're actually catching up to me, I think. By the way, has anybody else noticed that we've been doing this? Because I've noticed in the camp of Rick, whenever you go over any points on the Welsh marches, you get the sort of cab from side to side. Which is really cool. I love that. That's a really cool little feature of the route. What was you saying,
Simon? Oh, my God!
I was going to ask earlier, Tom, have you passed how long ago did you pass a tram in?
I don't bloody know. I'm at 56.5, so work it out yourself.
All right.
All right, I will. Anyway, Gwion, I've got a question for you. Oh god, you sound really miserable. Jeez, I don't know where to ask now because you sounded awful then.
Sounds miserable.
It sounded
because
like
people
you
are asking me questions.
What happens when you live in Swansea?
No, I'm going to actually ask you a genuine question.
Yes.
Oh shit!
It's about my computer.
Your pooter.
My pooter. Is it bad that when I opened it up yesterday, I found cobwebs inside of it?
I wouldn't say it's terrible, but you probably do want to make sure that it is a little cleaned out because...
I did clean it all out.
Could have an insect short component out or something. That wouldn't be good.
No. Well, what I've done anyway is I did use my little aerosol can in there. I've cleaned out the the filter at the front, and I've aired in all the side and taken... used a little thingy to get rid of all the cobwebs and things. So I'm presuming it should now be fine because I'm still covered with a dust sheet and everything. So I will keep an eye on that. I'll have to look again in a little while and see if there's any more, whatever. I think the thing I'm not looking forward to is if I ever have to upgrade it because I have no idea how I'm going to fucking do it.
Tech support.
On the bright side, your computer could be used as an insect killing machine.
I mean, I don't like spiders that much, so actually that wouldn't be too bad.
I'm going going through Hereford.
I think the only other question...
Now
the trouble is, Interpret, you're telling us this, right? But because you didn't start at the right time, we don't really care.
Oh, yeah. Way behind you. Because I did something so bloody slow. I've seen Liam stream and he's got like 240 PSI and I've barely got 120.
That's what you get for driving an N15.
Yep. I was tempted to use a CR72.
What?
Yes, go down with even more driving wheels. You'd
be if you did that.
Oh yeah, I would have been epic.
What, Liam?
I just said, yes, go down even more driving wheels.
Yep.
Oh yeah.
Whoa, that was rocky.
You see, me, I'm going to run out of water.
No, you're not.
I've got 1,500 gallons now in miles. I think it's like 200.
Yeah, but how far have you got to go?
49.
You'll be fine. Although if you do run out of water, that is a victory for DR1202. Hmm? Maybe.
No sleep till.
Oh god, I'm coming into Hereford. I don't know whether we should slow down or not.
I took it like 50.
Oh, I'm doing 90.
Yeah, you're gonna die.
I'm gonna slow down a bit.
Because you get taken into the outer platform. So.
Yeah, I went through it 70 and I was struggling a bit.
Well, the good news is Rick
has... ball energy.
Good news is Rick has really good brakes. Oh, that is a bit tight. Yeah. That was close.
Yeah, he's putting down the shoe very effectively, right?
But we made it. I did have to slow down quite substantially, but as I'm not really looking to beat Liam now. I came in at about 55. No, so a little bit. Yeah, about 50 or 55, I think. But okay. I did like rapidly slow down, to be fair.
Oh god, what have I done?
I'm entering the 30 limit. Oh.
Oh fuck.
James?
I have just done an H2 Atlantic.
Hey?
My water is at 1%, and I cannot inject anymore.
Oh,
don't worry, James. I'll bring it home for the Kings.
Fuck. Sorry, James. You're going to have to stop at Hereford, then.
Yeah, that's what I'm going
to
do.
Go to Hereford Model Centre. Come buy yourself a model train.
Yeah, you'll feel happier after that.
Sponsored by Greytech.
Sponsored by Model Tech for all your model railway needs.
Maybe Hereford should, stock Model Tech products.
We could ask them.
Oh, mate! You know what you can do? You can go and visit fucking Richard Hammond. He lives in Herefordshire.
Ask him to sponsor... No. Ask him to sponsor Model Tech. I'm sure he would. Yeah, he would. I reckon he would. I reckon if you asked him really nicely, he would.
He'd go, oh, right, these little tiny model trains. My mate James Ray loves them. Alright, tough crowd.
Yeah, sorry, Liam, it wasn't very funny.
Oh, okay.
Cobb, how are you getting on?
It's funny, Tom. Your face.
Hmm?
Cobb, how are you getting on? What's your distance now?
49.8.
You are less than a mile behind me.
I'm doing 68.
You are less than a mile behind me, my dude.
49.8.
I've realised I never actually advertised that I'm doing this over on YouTube, so no one over there knows we're doing this, and there's no point doing it now because we're like, you know, 2/3 of the way through.
Didn't think Princess Royal. That was another one.
I'd love to do this in the Princess. Oh, actually, the Princess might be really hellfire to take up the gradients.
Yeah,
not for
the other way.
Not for speed. I'm actually kind of tempted, actually, to go for a cigarette break.
Fucking absolutely run it back.
I am absolutely tempted to turn around at maybe go Shrewsbury to Bristol as soon as we finish this.
Bristol or bust.
But what I'll do is I'll probably finish. Well, obviously, we'll finish this race, see what happens there. And then just for a bit of a lark, I might take the princess from Shrewsbury to Bristol. Or, actually, no, because I want to take the princess. My trouble is, I want to take the Princess Royal up the West Coast Mainline for an actual proper stream at some point. So I'm actually kind of trying to work out what I could take instead. We'll think about it, because, I mean, it depends how long this race goes on for. Right, I'm back up to 80 miles an hour.
How far are you from Morton on Lug?
Oh, shit!
I'm point... Well, I'm just about to go through the marker now.
I'm 0.8 from Morton.
I'm actually kind of wanting you to overtake, because the Duke of Gloucester should absolutely be able to wreck Rick in one of these races.
Mm.
Just because it's an 8P express engine, this is a... Well, what is Rick? He's like a 9 or 10 MT freight engine.
MT?
Yeah, he might be a 10MT. If you go by what his actual tractive effort, if this design all worked in real life, which it wouldn't, would have been...
The F.
He'd have been MT for mixed traffic.
Bob did MT.
No, I'm saying that if it were a BR Loco, it probably would have been classified 10MT. Remember, neither Rick or Bob existed during BR Day, so neither of them ever got any sort of official power classification.
Yeah, but if they did, why would it be mixed traffic?
Because he's a mixed traffic engine, you claim. Because of the size of the drivers being in between a freight and a express. And plus, I mean, you know, he's not exactly a slouch, is he, Lear? I have been averaging about 80-odd miles an hour throughout this whole run.
Yeah, just for lore things, because Bob was just purely a freight-only engine, wasn't he?
I mean, he did pull some passenger trains, but he was more employed as a freight engine. Or he was employed as a bell end, to be honest. But, you know, we don't talk about that. Rick, on the other hand, is absolutely mixed traffic. Because he more than often pulls coaches, even though he prefers trucks.
That's complaining.
Are they coaches or trucks? Trucks, said the driver. Trucks, said Rick. Hooray! And he puffed off happily to find them. Sorry, James. I feel bad.
I didn't get 100 gallons of water left in the boil, so I could have still made it. But,
you could have made it, man. That's vital.
I was staring at the minimap too long, just trying to make sure if it was safe. Oh, fucking hell, I'm such an idiot.
Well, to be fair, James, I'll give you something. You've made it further than you normally make it in these races.
Well, normally I can make it to the end, but it's just like we just cut out too soon. Because we get bored.
Yeah.
I'm not dead last.
Anyway.
Yeah, can you imagine if there was a scenario where instead of it being like Gordon up on the Northwestern Railway, it was Rick instead. And just like, you know, that whole scene I just basically did with the whole, is it coaches or trucks? Trucks. Oh, trucks. I love trucks, said Rick as he puffed off to collect them. Now, if it was Bob, he'd just be like, fine, I'll take the trucks, whatever.
Whatever. You do it off the rails and Rick just teleports into the episode and goes, mate, trucks, I'll do it.
I'm then really explodes. Tempted to put Bob at least in the background somewhere as a bit of an Easter egg at some point. Once we get to the 30s. Oh my god, there's an idea. You know I said... I'm not going to do this, but do you know I said about an engine coming to replace Henry while Henry being rebuilt at Crewe? Mm-hmm. Just make it Bob on his test trial before going to the DR.
What livery would you have in
the DR Green? It would be... Oh no, I can't do any of that actually because I don't have a model of Big Bob in his original shape. For obvious reasons, because that would mean it would mean someone trying to animate the Penniston valve gear, which I don't think anybody particularly wants to do. Even though it's literally just Caprotti valve gear with two rotating rings on the outside. Now it's a fun little thought experiment, but I'm probably not going to do anything like that. Although I did try and explain the other day to somebody that I do still want to kind of do another season of TBRS because I don't really want to end Rick's arc where it ended, if you know what I mean. I would still like him to have more of more things to happen, because more stuff should and will happen to him. How are you doing for Waterloo?
1300.
And how far you got to go?
I'll be fine. 35.
Yeah, you're no trouble. I got 40.3.
So, LMS 40. Trains came on the island. Did they go to, like, Natford?
Why would they go to Natford?
I don't know. Fucking taking the LMS trains onto the island.
As far as I can see with what would have happened in Northwestern, at least, at this very moment in time in the show, at the very least, they go as far as Normanby and that's it. They don't go. Exactly. They don't go any further than Ballyhoo on the main line. They don't go any further than Normanby.
Any mainline trains, they would just leave at.
They just exchange at Vickentown. Well, Vickentown in the exchange station.
I'm just trying to figure out a way how, like, I don't know, alternate version of Bob in fucking LMS livery. I don't know.
Are you trying to do headcanon while trying to race?
Yeah, I mean, I've got nothing else to do.
Except trash.
Except, yeah.
Nah, the next station so the passengers have somewhere safely to get off after he's train.
Right, well, Kobe, I'm about to go through Leominster.
I'm half a mile from it.
Going through it now.
Yep, you passed me. I'm just about to go to it.
What's your mileage, Tom?
38.2. It doesn't matter, Liam. You're too far ahead for me to even attempt to catch up now. The only way I could win is either if you derail or you get AWS, like, twice.
Mm.
So, the challenge we set at the beginning of this, which is you said that Rick couldn't beat you and a king, I guess you win that one. But...
How's that?
Rick still looked good doing it, and he enjoyed himself today. So that's all that counts. Going to give him a pat on the smoke box when we're finished. In fact, I'm going to give a little pat to the little model I've got. Well done, Rick. You little legend. Well, I'll say little. Absolutely fucking massive legend.
Little engines can do big things.
Now, you see, if I'd done this at the Princess Royal, there's no way on this God's Earth I don't think I'd have been able to get up to the same speeds I've been doing. Because it's just not fast enough, in my opinion, the scripting on the Princess Royal. They're very grunty at low speed and to climb hills, but they just haven't got the speed. Speed is not a lot, mate.
Actually, I would disagree, but oh well, whatever.
Yeah, but Kobe, you've got a fat head and you're still behind me, so...
But for how long?
Probably about at least another 3 minutes, I'd imagine.
Well, what's your distance now?
My distance now is 36.2.
36.4.
And what's your speed?
101.
Yeah, you're going to both take me in a minute then. Because I'm doing 91. Well, can you do me a favour and catch Liam at least?
I will attempt
Considering you're both 6 miles
most likely to no avail.
Yeah, but Liam, we have still got 30-odd miles to go. A lot can happen in 30 miles. James could even come back with Super 47 and beat us all.
What about Smokey Joe?
Maybe.
Oh,
Smokey Joe would fly off the tracks. What about the jet-powered dragster?
Maybe. Yo, Gwyn, I've just thought of something we need to do in this server shortly. We need to set up a new role that I can assign to people just if I want them to be able to join the live streaming chat here. I reckon.
Should be straightforward. You don't...
Oh, no. Oh, no.
I don't think we need any third-party tools to do that.
No. We just need to basically set up like I've done with the Patreon lounge. No, I'm just saying that's something I think I should do because then if people are in like one of the other VCs, for example, and I just decide to go live in here and I'm like, oh, I fancy talking to Kobe. Oh, I fancy talking to you. Oh, I fancy talking to James. I can just quickly go to them and assign them, you know, live streaming.
All right, I'm going to fuck myself then.
Or like regulars for live streaming, I suppose I could do. Yeah. What have you done, Liam?
I said I'll go fuck myself then.
Well, I'm going to add you onto it, you pleb.
No, I'm just joking.
Oh no, we're just messing around.
Oh my god!
Have you crashed? Mm-hmm. Please,
is
please.
Is that actually sharp?
Yes, it's sharp. Liam, quick, emergency brakes. Emergency brake application.
Oh
die.
Oh my god.
I've run out of energy drink. I am not happy because I don't want to open my other one and I've got to be up until midnight tonight, goddamn.
Then open the other one you pled.
Nope. I can't. That one's for Tuesday.
Right, if I get AWS, I get AWS. I'm going to get some popcorn and to go to the toilet.
Okay. Plink AWS, plink AWS. Or even better.
What's my train, Gwion?
Even better, but even better, run out of water in the boiler.
Yes.
Which reminds me, thank you, I need to inject. So I mean, like, the thing with driving Rick as well is I'm so used to driving him, I can just, I know when to check him and everything. It's really odd. It's like I'm with, I'm synchronized with him, even though he is like a bit old and decrepit to run with, as in compared to like later stuff. I still find some joy in driving him. Could do a 2.0 update though.
This has remarkably low amounts of water usage, but I know exactly the reason why that is.
Because you've got a fat head, isn't it?
It's got, well, yes, yeah. But it's also because it's IHH.
Yeah.
Like, since we left, this actually left with 3,500 gallons for some weird reason. But at the moment, I've got 1,800.
I'm just under 3,000 gallons. Started with 5.
Nice. Right, well, my sit rep is, mainly for Kobe's sake, 30.3.
I'm 29.9.
Yeah, you're ahead of me then.
34.
We'll hunt down Liam. And Jen, get that Super 47 out.
Nah.
Ah.
Distinct something else instead.
Oh, is it a nuclear bomb?
Might be.
Nice. Can I watch?
Sure.
Yay! It's a pipe bomb! Yay!
I found the source of the ticking.
I found the source of the River Nile. It's actually my house. Oh, crap.
We should build up some more boiler pressure while I've got a chance.
Well, I can see Ludlow in 1.5.
0.8.
Is anybody actually watching Liam, like, Discord stream? Because I want to know whether he died yet.
I'm watching his stream, he hasn't died yet.
Damn it. Has he run out of water yet?
Not yet.
No, he's got an auto injector on. He's got an auto fireman something.
Oh, he got the auto fireman on. Oh, that's good, actually, because that'll just use more water.
Oh, actually, yes.
Because he's a 43? 49%.
Oh, yikes.
Passing Ludlow.
I'm not that far behind you now, though. I'm still about 0.6 behind you, then. That's still not bad.
Yeah.
Like I say, actually, in these sort of races, actually, when it's just a bit of fun like this, and when it's like a long-distance one, and we're all kind of close together. I mean, I know James is out because of an injector failure. But it's actually kind of just fun to do these long things sometimes.
Mm.
Right, going through Ludlow now. At 89. Might have to run this again at some point with something a bit faster, like a Hurst, perhaps. And maybe do like a proper service where, you know, proper service pattern where you do like, you know, start at Swansea, stop at like Neath, Port Talbot, I don't know, Cardiff, Newport, Acton Mainline, Highbridge and Burnham, Thurso, Birmingham New Street,
Paris,
Charles de Gaulle. Yet.
I fucked up my popcorn.
Ah, too bad you didn't fuck up your boiler.
No.
He's working on it.
Working on it? So have you derailed yet? I'm working on it.
Yep.
I'll get there eventually.
News, Liam.
Liam. Right in front of the final platform.
Liam.
Yes.
News for you. Corn on the Cob has now overtaken me.
Mileage, Cob?
24 and a half.
Yeah, so he's a mile, 1.1 ahead of me. But he's probably going faster than you. How fast are you both going?
I'm only going 83.
I'm doing 104.
Well, there you go. Maybe Kobe can bring this back after all. There's still 30 miles to go.
No, mate. Just going to notch up.
Well, can't you just notch diagonally instead?
What I've found with this is that takes forever to accelerate, but it does have quite a high top speed.
Hmm.
It does.
When you get up there, it stays.
Or does it? Dun dun dun. Dun 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 dun. Da 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 da. Da 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 da. I don't know what I'm doing now. Oh, I'm blown off apparently.
Oh yeah.
Oh my god.
What?
I've got 900 gallons.
Excellent. I think you should use it all right now.
We might actually run out of water.
To be fair, I mean, I'm down to 2671 gallons at the moment. And I had 5,500 when we started. So this is a long old route. It's all the hills as well that don't help.
It crippled me and I've never regained boiler pressure since.
Fuck! What up? So, Shrewsbury is like right near Bristol, isn't it? Not Bristol. Birmingham.
No! Shrewsbury right near Bristol! No!
Birmingham.
Maybe.
So, Liam, is your real name James May? Because you have no sense of direction, mate.
Someone should extend this to Birmingham.
Captain's sense of direction strikes again.
I'm sorry I'm not British.
I'm sorry that I'm not Australian.
Oh.
Passing Craven Arms.
I'm playing one-handed.
Oh, mate, I'm 1 point. You're a mile and a half ahead of me now, Kobe.
Putting my belt on the line for this one.
I think if Kobe catches up to you, Liam, and wins, I think you should donate £100 to your nearest charity.
I'll donate my belt to him.
No, you donate £100 to your nearest charity.
I don't even have £100.
Okay, donate your left lung.
Oh. I need that.
You might need it, but then some poor person in, like, you know, the deepest, darkest parts of the Northern Territory might also need your lung.
They're already dead.
Oh, whoops.
There's no one alive in the Northern Territory.
Did they get eaten by a kangaroo or something?
No, crocodiles. No,
they died of heat stroke.
Okay, cool. That's really mean. I hope someone didn't actually die of heat stroke.
Suddenly.
Going through Craven Arms.
So where are you now, Liam?
Shrewsbury.
You're not a Shrewsbury. Shut up.
14.
17.5.
Fuck.
And I'm just nearing the top of the gradient at 90, A gradient at 95.
This is actually problematic. It's time to notch up.
Look at all the sea Ludlow. It reckons I've got like half hour to make it still. my ETN.
I think Guion should explode rapidly, by the way.
I miss Guion's fat face.
I miss his as seen on TV moments.
As seen on TV.
As seen on the telly box. Rick, why are you so efficient?
Why not?
Big train. Big train moment.
I'm encountering problems.
You're encountering problems?
My dick don't work.
Did it? Is that, no. Is that because Guion looked at it?
Yes. Oh, it shrunk.
Ah. Right, well, my sit rep is I'm now at the back. I've got 17 miles to go.
You're not behind Intrepid.
No, I'm 27.
Yeah, but Intrepid doesn't matter because he didn't start at the right place.
How dare you, Intrepid is a very valuable human.
Loco. Do everything 100% wrong. Eventually you'll get something right.
Eventually you'll turn into a turnip.
Tell you what, it is statistically 100% impossible to get every 100% of things wrong unless you know 100% of the answers. And you're doing it on purpose.
That's true, random guess, eventually you'll get something right.
Meanwhile,
it's like on an exam. If you got every single question wrong on an exam, the only way you could do that is by knowing every single answer to the question.
Well, not answering any of them is technically getting them all wrong.
Huh. Ooh. I'm worried. Where's Cobb?
12.3.
I'm still 4 miles.
Jeez, you're 3 miles ahead of me now, Kobe.
I'm doing 93.
Oh man, sorry, Rick. Don't worry.
Rick fought his hardest.
He still owns my heart. He's fine. Hey, at least the Vale Tour people were happy.
Mate, they've been bounced around. Their necks broken.
they're lucky they're still leading the carriages, let's be honest.
They're all dead. They all fell off. They fell over. One of them fell into the toilet in one of the bathrooms.
One of them was catapulted out of the carriage.
One of them fell out the gangway at the back of the train. Somebody's actually been cut to pieces and roasted up for lunch in the buffet car. Another one thought that there was a connection corridor between Rick and the train. Tried to walk through the connection, got thrown outside of the train and started flying with the wings that suddenly grew out of their backs. Very strange things going on with this train today.
I slowed down way too far.
It's just your average day on the Welsh marches. Especially when you're on rail tour duty like we are.
Fuck, I need to stop eating the unpopped kernels. It's like really bad for you.
Everything's really bad for you.
Like my fish.
Yeah, fish are quite bad for you.
Fish.
69 PSI.
How have you only got 59... What? 59 or 69 PSI?
I'm obviously not driving as efficiently as I should be.
I mean, you've killed your boiler,
mate,
essentially.
My fucking kettle has a higher PSI than that. Yeah.
I think at this point, the turbo should just give up and take out a Super 47.
Nope. It reckons I've got just under a half hour left in my ETA.
Oh.
I'm doing under...
I've slowed down way too fast. I'm doing 87. If you gun it, you might make it close.
I'm doing 113.
What's your mileage?
7.8.
Woo!
12 miles to go.
114 now.
25.
How far have you got, Liam? Liam?
4.3.
He got 4.3, so... Oh, God, this could be close for them too, then.
I'm doing 7 miles to 114.
If I got AWS, this is really the closest thing since
Reiki's headphones.
Tom and his computer.
Oh.
I'm blaming my auto fireman for being pathetic this time. He slipped once and I have never recovered.
Auto fireman is for noobs.
Yeah.
Auto fireman is full of auto.
In my defense, I am still a very newbie when it comes to train sim. I think I've only got just over 100 hours in total.
Oh, my dear boy. Oh, my dear boy.
Question for you two, you lot, then. Did we want to do Shrewsbury to Bristol after this?
Sure, why not?
If we're quick.
Why not?
If we're quick? What do you mean, if we're quick?
Oh, just be quick about it, that's all.
Well, I'm going to go for a cigarette as soon as I've stopped at Shrewsbury.
Okay.
So they're going to be like, and I'm going to just put some music on in the background because, you know.
Yeah, I'm going to go for it.
Going to do everything.
Holy fuck, that was close.
What was?
He almost derailed.
AWS, one mind.
So the problem is, when we're talking to each other, all I can hear is, like, noise, because Interpret trying to talk with his, like, muffled microphone, and then Liam trying to talk, and then James trying to talk, and I have no idea what anybody says, so
look,
try
I'm
one
deaf.
At a time. I'm deaf as well, so.
Oh my god, hang on, I need to slow down. That's a 30 limit.
No, it ain't.
God, how far is Kobe? I'm worried.
Yeah, how far?
Oh my god, I got switched over. Holy fuck.
1.5 miles.
Oh, I'm 0.7. Holy shit.
It's gonna be close.
Hang on a minute.
I got switched over.
I'm still 8 miles out. Jesus. I got.
Yeah, you got fucked.
I got well and truly fucked.
What's your speed, Liam?
I'm doing 55.
Oh, 75.
Oh god, here we go.
How does this always happen, Cobb? The other one always catches up to you. Oh my god, that's a 15 limit.
Almost there. Just a bit more.
I'm stopping now.
30 miles an hour into the platform.
Who's going to stop first? This is tense.
15, 14, 13, 12, 11,
2,
10,
1,
9,
0,
8,
7,
6.
So close. So close.
I will say, though, from 6 miles behind, that comeback, eh?
That is a comeback, yeah. And I also came back.
I led off a little bit for you, Cobb.
No, you didn't.
No way, you didn't.
Well, I did. I do it for you too.
I thought you turned into a sausage roll. And you didn't get AWS, so I could catch up, eh? I ended up like something like
no, not that time.
I ended up about 6.5. Well, about 6 miles behind you guys in the end with Rick.
After 2 AWS.
Yeah.
Madness.
So that's it then, ladies and gents. I'm going to obviously get to the end of this one. The end result of this is that Liam won by a nanosecond again.
Calculated, folks.
Calculated. Kobe caught up right at the end in second place. I'm probably going to make third. James fourth because he failed at Hereford, but managed to probably eat a sausage roll while he was there. And Intrepid gets minus 957th place for not starting in the right place and taking it.
Being in
Oh, Guillaume. Honourable mention to Guillaume because he actually turned up for something but had gone incredibly quiet. He gets 2 points.
2 points?
Yeah, you get 2 points for actually...
That means I win, doesn't it?
No, you just get 2 points and there's no context to it.
But you're all negative a million.
No, that's Intrepid.
Yeah, that's me.
I got 400 million points. Liam gets 20 points, and Kobe gets 916 points. So
yeah, but you're the host, so you get an automatic 5 billion discount points.
No, I don't know. And Midland P turned up and then got served muted, so he gets negative 57 million points.
Minus 985 trillion to the power of 10,000 zeros.
So I guess on this day we have
we come to a
Great
conclusion.
Western Railway is better than British Rail
again.
By a millisecond.
It is a sad day for Great Western haters, isn't it, Kobe?
It's a sad,
sad day.
Here we go.
Hey, Liam. Are you ever going to quit gloating by any chance?
No. Because
are you ever going to quit laying down the challenge?
Kobe, if you ever win a race, you freaking gloat as well. And so do I. We all gloat because we're all horrible, horrible people.
Happen to do it more.
What win?
Yes.
Do you know what? If I could upgrade my computer and get better frame rates again, I could probably win some of these races again.
You reckon?
I reckon if I pay for Guillaume to come down here... a load of parts.
Oh dear.
And then get him to just basically like overhaul my computer. Like I'll give him a budget of like, I don't know, a grand or something to upgrade it. And then he comes down and fixes it. And then I come back and do this race again. I reckon I could win with a higher frame rate.
I guess at least this time I could use a car instead of the train.
Yes, very true. I don't have to pay for a train journey at least.
No, just my fuel.
I didn't pay for your petrol.
I have an Astra J.
An Astra J?
Oh shit, that's Shrewsbury.
Mm-hmm. Is that a Vauxhall?
Yes. Or Holden in your neck of the woods.
See how good your brakes are.
Oh, is it like Burger rough. King Hungry Jack's?
I guess.
Kind of. Why couldn't they do Vauxhall here?
Vauxhall, Opel, and Holden are all the same thing.
Yeah.
Or was the same thing?
No, they are the same thing.
Holden is fucking dead, isn't it?
I don't know. It's all owned by GM.
The Holden is dead.
Right, so guys, I just wanted to point out very quick, we are coming into Shrewsbury now.
Nice of you to join us.
Yes, hello.
The head unit on my car, you can configure... Well, the old one, I've replaced it since, but... It would let you configure the startup logo, and you had a choice from all the different GM manufactured cars. So I could
do yourself a favor, Guillaume.
Mm-hmm.
Scrap your Astra, get a nice Audi.
Oh, fuck shit. I ain't a cock.
Do your wonders.
I wouldn't suggest a Ford.
I would suggest a Ford, but everyone would just take the mick out of me as usual because I own a nice Ford Fiesta.
A Ford?
My Astra J is lovely. I love my Astra J. It's been a fucking champ.
Well, I like my Fiesta as well. See what I mean? It's instantly Ford's for losers. Boo, boo, boo. Thank Liam. I mean, to be fair, I did just lose this race, so
yeah, it is for losers.
Well,
yeah.
It doesn't have anything to do with the race, but
anyway, I'm gonna cut the stream here, I think, because
Enos.
Yeah. So that's it. What we can conclude. Is that Liam has won his challenge, which was to beat Rick, which he did quite spectacularly. Easy. Yeah. So he also beat Cobb by like a nanosecond. We've learned that the Great Western King is indeed overpowered. Rick is not powerful enough, and the Iron Horse House Duke of Gloucester
made
a massive comeback.
To be fair, Rick. is powerful enough that he was only 6 miles behind a king that stopped twice on its journey.
Yeah, but he still
is commendable for Rick. Rick is quite.
He still can keep up. He still can keep up with Duke of Gloucester. But then again, in service, Duke of Gloucester would have like fallen over and died.
Yeah, the original Duke of Gloucester would be like
dead.
I don't know. It'd be on the other side of the ocean. How far behind it?
Yeah,
in the Bristol
and
tunnel.
I think James would have actually like finished quite reasonably had it not been for his injector problems.
Yeah.
So the conclusion is then Liam wins, Kobe gets second, I get third, James gets fourth. Intrepid is like a million miles in some other universe.
He's still on a hill at the moment.
Guillaume managed to get point for non-participation just by showing up. He's like viewer. And that's basically the end of the stream. So we made it all the way from Swansea to Shrewsbury. So I managed to take Guillaume, part of the way at least. I managed to bring Guillaume to see Reece Arnold. So that's nice. Anyway, he didn't want to. Oh, that's a real shame.
Take him home.
I'm not taking him all the way back to Swansea. He can drive home.
Take him to Newport.
I'm not taking him to Newport either. I will take him as far...
Because you'll be passing Newport.
Will I? Oh, well, yeah,
we're going to Bristol.
Oh, yeah, we're doing that, aren't we? But I'm not going to stream that one. I'm just going to do that one for fun. Anyway, I'm going to mute myself for a sec because I'm going to end the stream there. So, cheers, everybody, for watching. Hope you all enjoyed this absolute fuck the cluck of a stream. And I will see you all next time. Goodbye. Have fun. Bye.